I think that many of you can relate with me when I say that we've heard this verse over and over again. And I think that in the same way, we can all agree that this verse is so deep and so beautiful. And because of that, this is actually my favorite verse. Well, ever since I was a teenager, it kind of just like resonated with me. But what does it actually mean? And today, I want to share with you what this verse means, but in reference more to the dating aspect of it. I believe without a shadow of a doubt in my heart that if we truly, truly, truly practice this verse, we could avoid so much pain, so much tears, so much heartache, so much unnecessary drama, so much things. If we only knew how to guard our hearts. And I'm talking from experience. Now, the question is, how do we guard our heart? Well, first off, you need to give all of it to Jesus, not a little piece of it here and there or little chunks of it, but all of it. No matter how broken it is, no matter how ugly you think it may be, just give it to Jesus first. Once you give it to Jesus, it's gonna be hard, very hard to give it to anyone else. But if you don't give it to Jesus, you'll end up giving it to like anybody. And the problem with us is that we don't want no one playing with our heart, but we actually hand it to people to play with it and to break it and to use it and abuse it. Another super duper important key is to being alert, being with your eyes open, paying attention to, the red flags. For example, you're talking to a guy and for whatever amount of time talking, or you could even be with him already, and he's mad at his mom, or his mom is mad at him, whatever the case is, but they get into this argument. And then he starts cursing his mom out and starts yelling at her and, starts pounding things. And mind you, you're sitting right there, you're listening to all that, And this is his mother. What makes you think that he's gonna treat you any better? Mamita, he's not gonna treat you any better, okay? And perhaps he'll treat you even worse. Sometimes it could even be physical. That's a huge, huge, huge red flag. Another example is, for example, you start talking to a guy and this guy doesn't work. And don't get me twisted. I understand that sometimes people go through struggles in life or people go through certain situations, but you gotta ask, like, how long have you been employed at your job? What's the longest that you worked in a certain place? How long has he been without a job, Those are huge red flags, because if he can't keep a job and you guys end up getting married, and you're gonna end up being a sugar mama. And those were just two examples that I wanted to give you guys, but that's just for you to understand the concept more of what are red flags. Many times we see the red flags and we You know what we do? We ignore them, and then we make excuses for these people's behaviors and character. And in those times, we're seeing our future already in our present. But guess what? You chose to ignore it. Or sometimes even other people point it out to us, or they notice things that maybe we don't notice. And you know what we do? We make excuses for these people. Again, don't do that. Don't ignore the red flags. Because then what happens is that time passes, you start flirting with this person, you start spending more time with this person. You start kissing this person, you start doing other stuff that obviously is not glorifying to God. And then the next thing you know, your heart is so deep in that in order for you to get it back, you're gonna have to go through hell. You're gonna have to go through tears. You're gonna have to go through so much pain, all because you ignored the red flags and you didn't guard your heart. There is way too many doors that, you know what, need to be closed in the name of Jesus. But the only person that can do that is you. So stop texting Pepito back that you know he's not good for you. Stop texting this chick that you know is not good for you. Delete them off your social media. Block them. The same goes with your phone. Block them off your phone. Delete their number, but close them doors. Guard your heart like if your life depended on it. Because guess what? It does.